We praise you, Jesus. There's nothing worth more that'll ever come close. No thing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen the sweetest of loves. My heart becomes free and my strength is undone. Oh, in your presence, Lord. Sing with me. Lord, Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome with your presence. Welcome this evening to Agape's live Word and Worship evening. We're going to have a very exciting, good time tonight in the presence of the Lord, because the Spirit is here with us and we want to plug in this evening and really hear from the Lord and know what He wants for us, what He wants to show us in the Word. He wants to drop a word into our ear tonight, so let us prepare our hearts through worship to receive that blessing this evening. I hope you're doing well. Hope you're doing well this evening. And I hope that you are excited to draw upon the Lord, because that's what we've got to do. Lord, we lift this up to you. Lord Jesus, you are our worship leader. Holy Spirit, lead us the way you want us to go this evening. We want to hear from you, Lord. Lord, lead us. We want to praise you, and we're going to start off with some praise. So, I'm just going to read very quickly a little bit of a psalm. Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name goes all the glory, for your unfailing love and faithfulness. Lord, we praise you this evening. To you, Lord, be the glory. We praise you. We praise you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. So we're going to start off with Open the Eyes of My Heart. We are allowed to dance this evening. If you'd like to have a little dance, it is possible. Well, it's allowed, it may not be possible. But I'm not looking at you, Janet, when I said that. Well, I was, but yeah. We praise you, Jesus. I'm going to focus now. We praise you, Lord.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining and light in your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. High and lifted up, shining and light in your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. Oh, I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love, love, love us and sing holy, holy, holy.
We'll cut that down. Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We are so blessed. We're so blessed. Thank you, Jesus. So many ways I could go. Gonna sing one. Let's sing some that you'll recognise. It's always good. You're so good, Lord. Shuffle blankets. Praise you. Yes, Lord, you're so, so good to us. Thank you, Lord, that you never change. You never get exasperated with us. You never say, well, that's it. He's done. I've got no more use for him. Thank you, Lord, your patience never ends. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We're going to sing Light of the World.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so highly exalted, glorious and never above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, for love's sake, it can't be more. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say,
which is Your Promise Still Stands.
Your promise still stands. Great is Your faithfulness. Your faithfulness. I'm still in Your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed me yet.
walking around these walls.
Walking around these walls. I could by now let fall, but you have never failed me yet. I know the night won't last, your word will come to pass. My heart will sing your prayers again.
Your promise still stands.
Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands, if this is my confidence. You never failed me yet. Never failed me yet. Walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall, but you have never failed me yet. I know the night won't last, your word will come to pass. My heart will sing your prayers again. Your promise still stands, great as your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands, this is my confidence, you never fail me yet, never fail me yet.
Never fail us. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We can trust and rely upon you. Thank you, Jesus. Let's Amen. Sing Amazing Grace.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
My chains are
Church, and welcome to our praise and worship and word this evening.
You are
very
mat.
Welcome.
I could sing of your love,
Connected for the fantastic word, which is just about a fun, and be blessed.
Yes, and be blessed.
Thank you. Oh, yeah.
Oh, hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Yes, our dear brother Mark is taking us to heaven, but we are on earth. Hallelujah. You that have decided to be at home, we thank God for your life. Hope you enjoyed the praise and worship, I know. But the best place to be is here, to enjoy it live. Live, hallelujah. So you have decided to be at home, no problem. Just stay tuned and follow us on our Bible study. We thank God for the life of our dear darling brother Mark that is really, really taking us wonderful time of praise and worship. That's the only thing that we are taking to heaven. There's no other thing. We leave everything. It's only praise and worship that is there that will remain. So if you don't come to train yourself, you'll be surprised that day. In heaven, you say you want to sit down, they'll say no, yeah, they don't sit down. You want to sleep? They say, no, here we don't sleep. We just worship and praise God. 24/7. No rest. So you have to begin to train yourself while you are here. So that when you reach there, they will not keep you out. So come and join Brother Mark. He will train you how to sing for 2-3 hours non-stop. But in heaven, it's 24/7. I doubt how you're going to do it if you are not here for 1 hour. Oh, yes. We thank you all that are watching at home. God bless you. Receive greeting for Pastor Daniel. They are doing moving from one place to another. So we thank God. He extend his greeting to everyone. Thank God. So we continue our Bible study today. Hallelujah. How walking in the power of the Holy Spirit. Walking in the power of the Holy Spirit. That's the theme of this month. Before we finish this term, this wonderful term, I believe that each and every one of us will begin to walk in the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Stay tuned. Get your Bible. Get your pen. You that are at home, get Bible. Get your pen. Get your notebook. So that after this, you're going to go through it and begin to pray that the Holy Spirit will help someone to begin to walk in the Spirit. Father, we thank you for this wonderful time. We give you glory, honor, and power. Thank you for the life of our dear brother Mark. Thank you for the life of each and every one of us here. Thank you, Father, for the anointing of praise and worship, Lord. You say it's not by power, it's not by man, but it is by your Spirit. Lord, you have anointed him in this generation, in this end time, Lord, to make people to be happy, to have hope in you. Because music in the world, Father, when you see it, we see people being happy in the music, but after when they go and commit suicide. But this one will remove us from the depression, stress, and suicidal thought to be happy, to be joyful, because it is motivated by the power of the Holy Spirit. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you that you will not leave us astray. We thank you. Holy Spirit, we are speaking about you, the third person of the Trinity. Give us understanding, give us knowledge, give us revelation. Holy Spirit, open our eyes, open our mind. Hallelujah. Show us the mystery to walk in the Spirit, in your power, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Benny, watching from Istanbul. God bless you, my son. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I'm talking about walking in the power of the Holy Spirit. You know, most of us, we are Christian, but we don't know how to walk in the power of the Holy Spirit. And that is the main important thing. When we walk in the power of the Holy Spirit, we become like Jesus. We become, hallelujah, like the children of God. Because the Holy Spirit is a partner, is our administrator, is our leader, is everything that we have to acknowledge in our Christian life. We should not leave him beside. We should believe, let him be in us, hallelujah, in us, to lead us, to guide us, in the name of Jesus. So we are talking about walking in the Spirit, in the power of the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit, we can't do anything. We can't even do this work of God. It's the Holy Spirit. He is our partner, beloved. So we want to understand why we should walk in the power of the Holy Spirit. We should walk in the power of the Holy Spirit because it is God himself. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit is God himself. He has all the attributes of God. He is omnipresent, he's omniscient, he's omnipotent. He is everywhere at the same time. Hallelujah. He is self-sufficient, he's so powerful. So we have to learn how to be walking in the power of the Holy Spirit. And we will understand that God is a spirit and he doesn't want to leave us astray. He doesn't want the enemy to kick us left and right because his power is so powerful. Let's start by Genesis chapter 3. I want us to start by in Genesis, the book of Genesis chapter 3 from verse 8. But Amma will read for us. Genesis chapter 3, 8 to 10.
Yeah. And they heard the voice of the Lord walking in the garden in the cool of the day. Mm-hmm. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord among the trees of the garden. And the Lord called to Adam and said, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard your voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked and I hid myself."
From verse 8 to 10, yeah? Yeah.
And he said, yes. Yeah, I was naked and afraid, and I hid myself.
Amen, amen, amen. Mira, do you have another version? Genesis chapter 3, let us, all of us, going to go together. I'm going to talk about it. It's not one person, hallelujah.
Okay, I'm reading. Mm-hmm.
Read it.
Then the man and the wife hear the sound of the Lord God, mm-hmm, as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And they hide from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. Mm-hmm. But the Lord of God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hide."
So I hide myself. My own is New King James Version. Said, and then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And they hid them from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I hear you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Hallelujah. You see, when man sinned, he began to run away. So you cannot walk in the Spirit, you walk in the power of the Holy Spirit when you have sinned. When we have sinned, we run away from the presence of God. We can see here that the Spirit of God got voice. God called Adam. So it means the Spirit of God has got voice. We are hearing the voice of God all the time. He called and said, "Where are you?" Adam listened. He heard the voice that God was calling. He said, "I hear you calling me." How many times God is calling us and we are hearing him and we are ignoring his voice? How many times that God is calling us? He said, "I hear you calling me." But because, "I hear you calling me, but I hid myself in the trees." He said, God was asking him, "Where are you?" It doesn't mean that God didn't know where he was. But he was trying to know, find out that if really he understood where what he did. He said, "Where are you?" It's the same thing every day. Walking in the Spirit. God wants to walk with us in partnership. And he's calling us, "Where are you? Where are you? Come and let me partner with you in this work." Hallelujah. And then the Adam said, "No, I'm hiding from your presence." Sometimes we do a lot of things, we think we are hiding from man, but we cannot hide from God. Hallelujah. He said, I'm hiding from you because I am afraid, because I was naked. You know, when we sin, when we began to sin, that the Spirit of God is in us and we began to sin, the glory. If that nakedness means the glory of God depart from him. He was clothed with the glory of God. That was the cloth that he was. So when the glory of God come out from you, we are naked. We are exposed to the enemy. So the glory of God that was clothing Adam left him. And that's why he was naked. He feel that he was naked. Hallelujah. So when we walk in the power of the Holy Spirit, we are clothed with the glory of God. Amen? Amen. We are clothed with the power of God. The glory of God will clothe us, will hide us. Amen. So we need to aspire to walk in the Spirit. And what is the criteria to walk in the Spirit is love. Love is one of the things, and obedience. Hallelujah. So when the man hid himself from the Lord because he was afraid, because he has sinned, that one sin is rebellion. And that's what is making most of us Christian, we rebel that one sin. He rebel and he run away from the presence of God. God did not drive him. He first of all ran away and hid himself because he could not stand. And then he said, "Who told you that you are naked? How do you know that you are naked?" You see, when the glory of God depart, our conscience began to judge us. When we do something that is not good, we know very well that what we are doing is not good. Because we feel that the presence of God is no more in us. And we cannot experience the power to walk in the Spirit. Walking in the power of the Holy Spirit means we need to have the conscience of walking with God. Hallelujah. We need to be holy. Holiness is not... You know, some churches nowadays, they say when you don't tie hair tie, you don't put trousers, you wear long skirt up to you, they don't see your feet, and you close your eye, that is holiness. That's why they think, they say that is holiness. No, that's not holiness. You can put all those things, but in you, you're still sinning. You're still doing the things that is rough, not good. So holiness is mindset. Hallelujah. It's not have condemnation mind. So when we are holy, it means we know that we are walking with God, it means we know that we are not condemned. And God doesn't condemn us, and we should not condemn ourselves. Hallelujah. God, he said, who told you that you were naked? So he condemned himself already, that I'm naked. It's not God who told him. He already put himself in the position of guilt. Hallelujah. Instead of him to repent and come to God, he began to ask, tell the Lord, this is the woman that you brought in. That is what that taking his responsibility and giving to God. He said, you brought me this woman in this place. That's what makes me to sin. And that's what is happening every time. We don't take our responsibilities. We always say, because of this person, because of that person, that is why I'm doing this. And because it started in Genesis. Hallelujah. So walking in the Spirit is something that we need to aspire every time. We need to ask God to direct our footsteps all the time. We need to, I always say when we're walking in the Spirit, we should not say we need big miracle to walk in the Spirit. We have to start, first of all, to love these little children. Love our enemy. So therefore, we are walking in the power of the Holy Spirit, because love conquers everything. Love is so powerful. So when we love our enemy, we began to walk in the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And that's what happened here. God loved Adam and Eve. He did not allow them to go naked. He clothed them. Not only clothing them with leaves that they went to cheap things, and that's what is happening in these days. When we sin, or we run away from church, or we run away from the presence of God, from the fellowship with God, we began to go and eat with those people that are eating in the floor. Meanwhile, God has made us to eat with the king and prince on the table. So Adam ran away and he clothed himself with leaves. But God did something that shows love. He killed an animal. You know the skin, anything, you see, leather jacket is very expensive. Hallelujah. Pure leather is very expensive. He clothed him with a jacket, leather jacket, the skin of an animal. It's very expensive. It's not any person that put it, that skin. That skin, not everyone. You need to, they call it bran. It's very, very expensive. So God said, the leaves you have used is so cheap. Well, let me kill an animal and clothe you with the skin of an animal. Hallelujah. And then he put the blood, and that is how Adam began what God wants him to be. Hallelujah. So therefore, we are talking about walking in the Spirit, walking in the power of the Holy Spirit. We started from Genesis, which is so powerful. Hallelujah. So let us go to Exodus. You know, that is what we call doctrine. Doctrine is anyone that brings doctrine to you, and it can start from Genesis, from the five Pentateuch Bible. It just take one verse, and it cannot explain it from Genesis to Apocalypse, Revelation. It just take pick. You see, Genesis is what is the beginning of everything. So when the doctrine starts from Genesis, you go to Exodus, you go to Numbers, and that's why Jesus said, I've come not to abolish the law, but to fulfill it. To fulfill it. See, because the law was talking about me, the prophet, they talk about me, the apostle, it is from, they were talking everything that I was the one to come and fulfill it. So everything about the law, I did not come to abolish it. I didn't come to abolish it. I come to fulfill it. I come to validate. That's the meaning. I've come to validate it, to say, yes, it is true. Hallelujah. So Jesus has come to validate what? That the power of the Holy Spirit is real. It's real. Exodus chapter 24. Let's go there. Hallelujah. The book of Exodus means departure. Exodus means departure. Is that book means it's when the children of Israel, they began to think about departing, leaving Egypt. Book of Exodus 24, verse 9 to 8. It's a long verse, eh? Oh my God. Yes.
9 to
18.
18. Mm-hmm. Then Moses went up, also Aaron, Nadab, and Abihu, and 70 of the elders of Israel. And they saw the God of Israel. And there was under his feet, as it were, a paved work of sapphire stone. And it was like the very heavens in its clarity.
Amen.
But on the nobles of the children of Israel, he did not lay his hand. So they saw God, and they ate and drank. Then the Lord said to Moses, come up to me on the mountain and be there, and I will give you tablets of stone, and the law and the commandments which I have written, that you may teach them. So Moses arose with his assistant Joshua, and Moses went up to the mountain of God. And he said to the elders, wait here for us until we come back to you. Indeed, Aaron and Hur are with you. If any man has difficulty, let him go to them. Then Moses went up the mountain, and a cloud covered the mountain. Now, when the glory of the Lord rested on Mount Sinai, and the cloud covered it 6 days, and on the seventh day he called to Moses out of the midst of the cloud, the sight of the glory of the Lord was like a consuming fire on top of the mountain in the eyes of the children of Israel. So Moses went in the midst of the cloud and went up into the mountain. And Moses was on the mountain 40 days and 40 nights.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Who can tell me what I spoke before about it? I said the cloud of the glory of the Lord. That was happening. The cloud of the glory of the Lord filled the whole mountain. You see, when we walk in the spirit, we walk in the miraculous. Hallelujah. When we are walking in the spirit, we are walking in the miraculous, and we are walking in the supernatural power of God. We can see how God called Moses, say, come up here, and left the other ones. It means partner with God. Moses was, he was a partner. That is, he was partnership with God, partner with the Holy Spirit. So when we partner with the Holy Spirit, we are now walking in the supernatural and the miraculous. Things began to happen that we don't even understand. I love God because God always separates those that he wants him in those days. He will separate. He said, Moses, come out. He could have asked all of them to come out. Why Moses? Because he was that leader that God chose. Why only Moses? Because all of them, they went up. He said, no, all of you, come up here. But he needed one person that can understand him, that can walk with him, that will not depart from him, that will not disobey him. He said, come on here. Come and meet me here. When Moses went up to the mountain, the cloud covered it. That's the glory of God. That's the power of God. The cloud covered it. And the glory of the Lord settled on Mount Sinai. The glory of God revealed the power of God. Hallelujah. And that's what is happening. We need the glory of God. Anything we are doing, if we want to walk in the spirit, we really need to ask God, God, let's fill this place with your glory, with your presence, with your power, with your supernatural power. Fill my life with your glory. And when the Lord began to fill our life with his glory, we began to walk in the supernatural power, hallelujah, in the miraculous. We began to do things that man cannot perceive. We are not afraid. You will not be afraid of anything. Moses was not afraid of anybody. He was not afraid of Pharaoh, because he knew that God was his master. The Lord was with him. He was walking in the supernatural. So when we began to walk in the Holy Spirit, walk in the power of the Holy Spirit, one thing we need to know, that the Holy Spirit is not with us to give us fear. It's not with us to make us be intimidated. Because he's the one. You know, one thing that I've come to understand why Christians, they don't want to take their authority, because they don't know that the Holy Spirit is the one doing the work. Amen. Hallelujah. We're not the one doing it. It's the power of God in us doing the work. The only thing we have to allow him just to surrender. Just to surrender ourselves for him to do the right work in our life. The Holy Spirit is the one doing the work. We don't do nothing. And that's what Jesus Christ said in John. He said, without me, you can do nothing. We try to do things on ourselves. We try to make things happen by our strength, by our education, by our relationships, everything. But if the Holy Spirit is not there, we are just wasting our time.
But we need the Holy Spirit to be, to guide us, to walk through us, to do. And that's why we see in the book of Acts of Apostles, we see that the apostles, they understood the power of walking in the Spirit. And that's why they were doing, they were changing the world. They called them world changers. Because they were not the one doing the work. It's the Holy Spirit that was doing the work. The only thing they needed to do is just to obey. Just to abide by what the Lord was telling them. What the Lord, they were hearing the voice of the Lord, and they were doing what the Lord was telling them. And there is, you know, we thought there is a conflict in our spirit. The flesh and the spirit is fighting, fighting. The spirit wants to do the things of the Lord. The flesh wants to do the things, our desire, our emotion. So these two things, it's a fight. So if we come to understand that, we have to surrender according to the book of Romans chapter 12, verse 1 to 2. It says we need to be renewing our mind. Renew your mind. Do not conform your mind yourself with the things of the Lord. But let our mind be renewed by the word of God. Every time we need to remind ourselves that God, you are the one doing this thing in my life. I'm not the one doing it. So then we began to walk in the power of the Holy Spirit, and God will be walking in us in a miraculous way. And the Lord will be doing things that no man can do. That will be surprised. I said, let me just give a bit of testimony. Because when I began to, in my early age of believing, when I was in bed, the Holy Spirit used to take me to the hospital to pray for the sick, to pray for people. You know, when you obey the Holy Spirit, you will see miracles happening. Things was happening. I was just obeying, going to the hospital, praying for the sick, and everything. They were calling me, come here, somebody sick, and I would go in church. My husband was not a believer by then. So it was very hard. Sometimes we just drop me and say, you go to the hospital, and just go. And then come, find your way home. You see, Anna, that's why I will keep on doing. One day I went to the hospital, and the woman, they called me to come and pray for that day. She was sick. And when I entered into her ward, the doctors, they were attending to her, and the nurses, they said, wait outside. So I was outside waiting, and I think it was around 10 o'clock, 9, 10 o'clock. I heard in another ward, people were crying, and they were shouting, they were crying, tumbling. I said, but what is happening here? The Holy Spirit told me, go there. I said, I didn't come. I was talking with him. I was fighting. I said, but I didn't come for, I came to pray for this woman. You are telling me, say, you go there. Go and pray. Somebody, something is happening there. I said, no, no. I was fighting. I said, Lord, I'm not going. If I go there and then they beat me and tell me that you asked me to come and pray to this lady, what will I say? At that time in Cameroon, if they see that you are born again, it is high persecution, they can beat you, do any kind of things. No, just disgrace you. So I was fighting before I know, because God wanted to show his power. I was there for a mission. But before I know, I don't know the power that moved me from where I was to that world. Before I know, I was in front of that people, and the young girl, she was dead. I was in front of them. And they wanted to now wrap her, put her in the stretcher, take her to the mortuary. I just stood in front of her and I began to pray. Everybody just, you know, God is so powerful. When God wants to walk, you can't touch anything. Everyone, the doctors, the nurses, everybody just do that. It may be her sister, it may be her brother, it may be her family. And so I said, no, this hallelujah people, this hallelujah people, they're the one. So as I finished praying, the girl just woke up on the stretcher. They were taking her to the mortuary. See, she just woke up. They went and called the mother, they called the father, they called the grandmother. God have sent an angel. Oh, come here. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Everywhere, the whole hospital was shaking. And I was surprised. But what happened? I couldn't understand. Like, what happened? Yeah. Even the woman that I came to pray for, I didn't even go there again anymore. So the family, they took me, they were just carrying me up. And I said, but why people carry me? What is all this? Put me down. They said, no, you are not leaving this place. You are not leaving this place. What? How do you know us? Question they were asking, I could not answer. This is supernatural working of the Holy Spirit. Amen. From there, my perspective changed about God. Amen. Everything just changed. Everything, I just began to look, and then everywhere, the churches, oh, somebody, the die in the hospital, these hallelujah people. And then my pastor was preaching and he was talking. I said, I was the one that went to the center. So what happened? I began to explain to the church what happened. You see, when you learn to walk with the Holy Spirit, it will just, because my desire was to pray for the sick. So he said, this is one of the things that I brought you here. I brought you here to pray for the sick because I was in the hospital. And the Lord told me, your mission is to go back to the hospital and pray for those that are sick. Those that dead will be raised. And that's how the Lord used me to, I cannot count how many dead people. I can't count it.
Amen.
I can't count it. And it always happened. Not that I just imagine I go there and say, oh, no, it just happened in the miraculous way. All the time, just in the miraculous way, you don't even expect it. You just see it happen. And the Lord will just say, pray. You just see it. God will say, pray. I said, somebody is there. You just ask me to pray. How can I pray? Before I know, my hand is there. So when God wants you, you don't plan it. I think that's the thing. You don't plan it when the Holy Spirit, you just allow yourself to be used. You don't say, okay, one little boy died one time, one little baby of one lady, one pastor died, and I traveled to another city, and the people began to say, if evangelist definitely is here, she's going to pray, and then they brought the lady to my house, the little boy to my house, and I wasn't there. And then they were calling me, I was in Douala, and they say, where are you? Where? I said, I'm in Douala. I said, oh, this baby is dead and we are in your household. I said, no, God didn't want me to be there. I'm burying the baby. He's dead, he's there. Pastors are there, they can pray. I said, no. You have to come. And the Holy Spirit didn't move me. I told them, no, I can't. It's not God. This is not God. This is not God. It is not God. And they left the baby. The baby slept in my house. And then they took the baby back and it wasn't good. If God wanted me to be there, I would have been there that time to pray. You see, so sometimes we don't understand how the Holy Spirit works. We just need to allow the Spirit of God to work through us in a supernatural way. That we have to just abide ourselves, totally surrender ourselves. The Lord, use me. Just use me. Just use me. Just use me. Even here in the hospital, I was grateful. That boy was just dead. 14 days, no shaking, life support. He was not praying, not passing, nothing. The whole family came here. As I just stood there to pray, the Holy Spirit said, go. I said, okay, the Spirit of God asked me to go. And it was so miraculous. The Holy Spirit said, 7 days, this boy is going to wake up and he's going to eat and everything. And before the 7 days, everything was normal.
Amen.
Somebody that was just there, life, he didn't even conscious for 14 days. He's here in college, a Romanian guy. They don't come here, you know, because it's just, you know, sometimes God just wants to make people understand that he is God. We don't need to manipulate him. We don't need to manipulate and make some kind of cinema. So walking in the power of the Holy Spirit, we first of all need to believe that the Holy Spirit is powerful. We have to believe in our subconscious. We have to meditate on it. We have to be partner with him. We have to listen to the voice as other. I hear your voice because he speaks. I hear your voice. The voice of the Holy Spirit is so powerful and it gives us direction. Acts chapter 10, verse 19. And that's why the Bible says, God said, come up. Moses heard the voice of God, the Lord. God did not come down and took Moses and say, okay, let us go. Come on. No, it was the voice that Moses heard. Because Moses was in a partnership with God. He was a companion of God. So he was always hearing the voice of the Holy Spirit of God. Hallelujah. So we have to learn how to hear the voice of the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 10, verse 19.
While Peter thought about the vision, the Spirit said to him,
yes.
Behold, three men are seeking you. Arise therefore, go down with them, doubting nothing, for I have sent them.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So we have to continue. We have to ask the Lord to open our understanding, to hear his voice. Peter was, I love the Holy Spirit. You see, when Peter was still thinking about the vision, because he was praying and the Lord showed him a vision about the bird, if you go up a bit, you hear what the Lord was talking to him. And he was about thinking about the vision. The Spirit said to him, get up and go downstairs. So, you know, sometimes we don't even understand how the Spirit is saying. So many people say, I've never heard the voice of the Holy Spirit. But it speaks in our inner spirit. It speaks to us every day. The only thing is that we have not cultivated our internal spirit to hear His voice. That's the difference. When we cultivate our spirit, when we bring our spirit to hear the voice of the Lord, we will always understand what the Spirit is saying. And then the fish, and then Simon, three men are looking for you. Get up and go downstairs. Do not hesitate. Go with them, for I have sent them. Is there any man? No. Peter didn't see any person coming. But he heard the voice. The Spirit speaking to him. Go. How many times has the Spirit telling us to do something and we don't do? If we don't obey the first one, beloved, and even the second one, he won't say anything. That's what I've come to learn with the Holy Spirit. If you began to obey the Spirit of God from the first day, the little thing, that's how you began to train you to begin to hear His voice, and it will take us to do supernatural. But if we don't obey the little one, forget it. Truly. Because He will not like to work with someone that is disobedient. He will not like to, He has told us do this. And later on, you don't do it. He will not tell you, see, because you did not hold this telephone, I will give you the mic. No, I asked you to hold the telephone. Take the phone. He said, no, I'm not taking the phone. I need but the mic. Say, take the phone. No, I'm not. I need the mic. He said, okay, let's talk on the phone. Hallelujah. So when we don't learn to obey, I always tell people, I say, if you don't learn to obey the little things, if you don't obey the little things, don't forget the kind of vision that you have in your life. Forget anything. Because God wants to use us to obey, train us to obey. He told Moses, come. In the bush, he said, Moses, turn, look, I'm calling you. Go and speak to you. From the beginning, Moses began to obey. Then now, you began to walk with the Spirit of God. You began to experience the supernatural. You began to experience miraculous things. And God began to trust you, have confidence. But if you say, do this, you say, no, I want to do this. I want to do that. He can't walk like that. Mm-hmm. And that's one thing we as Christians, we forgot to know. We are forgetting to know that God wants us to be, first of all, obedient to the small things. Be obedient. If we want to walk with in the power of the Holy Ghost, we need to be obedient in little things that the Lord is asking us to do. And when we are obedient to that little things, it will begin to move with us in the next step. Gradually, the second step. All the time, it will be moving with us from one step to another. He knows that, okay, you have obeyed the first step, and you have patiently, endurance, we love, and it takes you. If you don't obey the first step, forget it. Let the anointing flow in your head. No, like sun or fire. That is not God. That's what I've come to learn. That's my own experience. And when we began to obey God with the little things, the little things, the Lord began to work miraculously. I always say, young Christian, because I have a lot of men, children, I have got a lot of pastors and so on that I'm mentoring in Cameroon, here, all over. I always tell them that if you don't obey the first thing that the Lord has asked you to do, don't think about the second thing. First of all, train yourself to obey, no matter how it is, how hard it is. That is your school. That is your university. That is your college. So first of all, graduate there, then you go to university. I've never seen somebody, I've never graduated in the college, and from the primary school, they just project and go to university. No. We have the school of God, that the journey of, and God is taking us gradually, and that's how we become. And then we began to walk with God. Hallelujah. So Peter has trained himself to be hearing the voice of the Lord. He has trained himself. He has been with Jesus. He trained himself to know how the voice of God is. He knows the voice of the devil and the voice of the Lord. He trained his ears to listen to the voice of God. So if we don't train our ears, anything that is contrary to the word of God is from the devil. So we should not listen to what is contrary. If we want to walk in the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ said, as my Father sent me, I obey him. I obey my Father. And I walk in love. So if we don't train ourselves to walk in the Spirit of God, in obedience, we will not achieve the purpose of which God has called us. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. So we need, first of all, to train ourselves to walk in the Spirit of God. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 5. Let's see what it's saying there. Let me just jump in the New Testament. Peter trained himself. He said, go. Men are waiting for you. Just go there. You hear. And obey. And go and do what they say you should do. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Holy
Spirit. 1 Thessalonians 5, 5.
Yes.
You are all sons of light and sons of the day.
Yes.
We are not of the night nor of darkness.
Continue.
Therefore, let us not sleep as others do, but let us watch and be sober. For those who sleep at night, and those who get drunk are drunk at night. Mm-hmm. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and as a helmet, the hope of salvation.
Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. 1 Peter chapter 5 from verse 5. He says, you are all sons of the light. All of us, we are sons of the light and sons of the day. We do not belong to the night or to darkness. This is not talking about the night that is coming that we are going to sleep. No. It's talking about sin. It's talking about things that are contrary to the word of God. He said, we are sons of the light. And so Christ said, we are the light of the world. We are the salt of the world. So it means that wherever we are, we should reflect the light. We should reflect the light. How it means we cannot compromise with the word of God. Someone wants to compromise with the things of God, we are the light. We bring light in the person's life. We are not in darkness. We are not walking in sin. So then let us not be like others. Who are those others? It's a disobedient children like others who are asleep. But let us be alert and self-control. Let us be alert and self-control. Hallelujah. Let us be alert and self-control. For those who sleep at night means you don't do the things of God, just sleeping, just. No, you don't know what to do in the household. We don't know what to do in the vision that the Lord has given you. You just procrastinate. I'll do it tomorrow. I'll do it next tomorrow. I don't have time. No. These are sons of the night. They sleep. We always sleeping. I'll do it next day. Oh, no, there's no time. I don't have money. I don't have this. Somebody told me I don't have money to start the church. So how can you not have money to? The Lord that I call has got all the money. Hallelujah. God has called us, got all the money. He has everything. The only thing he wants us to do is to be obedient. We should not sleep. We should do the things of God. We belong to the day. Let us be self-controlled. Putting on faith and love as breastplate. Hallelujah. Putting on faith and love, as I said. Faith and love. Faith and love, beloved. We have to, you that are listening to me, if you want to see, I'll put it on YouTube. You can continue to let us be the son of the day. People in the night sleep. And when you sleep, you forget everything that you have to do. It means begin to do the things that God didn't ask you to do. Competition, comparison, you know, lack of patience, lack of self-control, lack of endurance, lack of forgiveness. All these things are the things of the night. They bring night. They bring darkness in our life. They bring darkness. And the Holy Spirit do not dwell in the body that is dark. He's a spirit of light. So he wants to walk with us and through us. So that's why we need to study the word of God and know that God wants us to do his work. because the whole place is in darkness. So God has called you and I to take the light to the city. How can someone be in darkness? When you talk to me about Jesus Christ, he said he doesn't know about it. It's in darkness. His mind is in darkness. Many people don't know Jesus. We met a guy on Sunday. He said he loved God, but he doesn't know why he doesn't want to go to church. He doesn't know why. He said he told us that he feels bad because when he's speaking to people about Jesus, they look at him as if he's crazy, he's mad. He's going to come here on Sunday. He said he's going to come on Sunday. We preached to him, we gave him, we said, you come. When you come and you begin to study the word of God, you will see how darkness will flee away. The thing darkness will go away, and you begin to see the potential that the Lord has deposited in you. You'll be a different person. And you were so happy. And you pray that God, many of them, many, many young people, they are still in darkness. So I'll call Brother Mark to come and lead us for some time. Hallelujah. Pray for us for this wonderful time. And we believe that you that are watching us, hallelujah, you change your way of thinking about walking in the power of the Holy Spirit. Change your way of doing things of God. Change your way of doing things of the in the house of God. And then God will begin to use you in your generation in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Fantastic.
Amen.
Power of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Going out of the Word and out of our apostle. Wow.
Amen. Amen.
Just trying to process all of that.
Process all that. It's not easy.
People risen from the dead.
Yes.
You know, blows your mind.
Yes, really. Yes,
amazing.
Yes.
Amazing. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
And we can aspire to have the faith to do that. Mm. It's not, God's no respecter of persons. He hasn't given a different, we have the same spirit as Delphine has.
Yes.
She just has the faith to go out
faith.
And walk in it.
Mm-hmm.
And Lord, help us to have that faith to try and walk out and do things that just in our sensible mind may seem crazy. Mm-hmm. But praise God.
Amen.
That is faith.
That's faith.
So thank you so much for staying with us this evening.
Amen.
And we're going to sing a couple more songs.
Amen. Yes.
And wind is blowing.
Yes. Amen.
We're going to finish off with Oh Happy Day. And I may risk another song, but this song is a bit radical and I'm not
sure. Yes.
I'm sure on the launch up, thank you. Yes. Greatest thing in history, death is beating me, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. The anti-grave, like eternal, you have won the day. Sing out, Jesus is alive. He's alive. Happy day. You watch my sin away. Oh, happy day. I'll never. Thank you. you, Lord. Yes. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Thank you for this evening.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody will now do the blessing because I still don't have it. Thank you right now.
Amen.
So I don't
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for this evening, for this powerful message word we hear.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit always leads us where He wants us to be.
Yes.
He wants us to go. And may we receive the fruit of the Holy Spirit that
Amen.
We go spiritual with the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. For this moment of our life, all of us here and those ones who are watching us through the meetings,
yes.
May they receive also your Holy Spirit and
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
As
you want them to be. May our life change from today, from this message
we yes.
receive, and may we grow according to the will of God.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Tomorrow?
God bless you this evening. We are going to be in Coventry City Centre tomorrow, probably around 12 o'clock. So be with us.
Yes.
And it is a fantastic time. And you'll be doing God's will. And He will bless you for
yes.
it abundantly.
Amen.
So God bless you tonight.
Yes.
Grace. Take care until next time.
Yeah. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Yes, hallelujah, I will dwell. Shalom, shalom.